On the line with us, Tom Perez. He is the chair of the DNC, former secretary of labor in the Obama administration. Democrats.org is the website. You can tweet him at Tom Perez. Tom, Chairman Perez? Welcome, Secretary Perez.
I always you got it right to begin with, Tom.
Okay, thank you. Welcome back. I was just talking about how if the Democrats, there's this piece in Daily Beast, which is almost like voter suppression, talking about how every time, all the way back to Harry Truman, every time a president loses the House during an election in his first term, the first midterm after he's elected, he goes on to win re-election because he then uses the opposition party as a foil for the next 2 years. I think I disagree with this. I think that the theater that can be done by having chairs of individual committees conduct hearings using subpoena power could be overwhelmingly powerful and could just completely blow that out of the water. But it'll only happen if your committee chairs are schooled in how to do theater. There's no doubt in my mind Adam Schiff knows how to do it, and Maxine Waters knows how to do it. But there's a bunch of others who, you know, I hope you're sitting down with some good consultants and talking about how do we do, because theater is basically all you're going to have, but, I mean, it could be damn powerful stuff. What do you think?
Well, we've got others too, like Elijah Cummings from my home state of Maryland.
Yeah, he's very good.
Not been shy, and they understand the importance of oversight. Yeah, we all know that Donald Trump is the most dangerous president in American history, but I think what is undertold about this is the appalling silence and complicity of Republicans. And that's one of the many reasons we need to elect Democrats tomorrow. Remember in the Obama administration, Tom, when a scandal was when Barack Obama wore a tan suit?
Right, or when he held a coffee cup while he was saluting the Marine at the helicopter.
Yeah, I mean,
or put his feet on the desk. Oh, my God.
Yeah. Oh, geez. Yeah, throw the bum out. Yeah, I mean, it's the culture of corruption here is off the charts. I mean, goodness gracious, the former HHS secretary, that's like 10 scandals ago.
Yeah.
And you know, this is taxpayer money. You've got HUD, you've got EPA, you've got
Interior.
Yeah. Goodness gracious, you know, Jeff Sessions. The list goes on and on. And frankly, the more important point I would make, or the equally important point I would make, you know, to dispute that piece, is that people are suffering right now. People are going to bed tonight wondering, am I still going to have coverage for my pre-existing condition?
Right.
People are wondering, you know, is anyone going to do anything about the
fact that that's the other half of the theater, too. I mean,
100%. I mean, this is about real people. Our party is about helping real people deal with today's problems and build a better tomorrow for them and their kids. That's what we're doing in the Democratic Party.
I absolutely agree. And we live in a political world, and we have media that is entirely driven by theater. And we've seen this is how Donald Trump became the Republican nominee. It's how he became president in large part was, you know, the media giving him $2 billion worth of free airtime. Why? Because he was telegenic, because he knew how to do reality TV, because he knew how to basically, you know, get on TV. And, you know, we talked about the committee chairs and the subpoena power. The other thing is, if you control the House, if you can keep your caucus whipped into line, you can start passing really cool legislation, even though it won't be made into law. You know, people are not going to stop suffering as a consequence of this because the Senate will stop it or Trump will stop it. But, you know, passing a Medicare for All legislation, passing, you know, good climate change legislation, passing a minimum wage increase, passing, I mean, you know the priorities.
Infrastructure.
But if you pass them.
Infrastructure bill that puts people to work.
But see, this is the thing. You know, when George Bush was president, he wanted to pass legislation that would make it easier for the Koch brothers factories to dump more air pollution into the air. What did he call it? The Clear Skies Initiative. He wanted to pass a law that made it easier for the coal companies to dump waste into rivers. What did he call it? The Clean River or the Clean Water. You remember what it? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah,
you know, they
remember.
Came up with a law that basically guts our civil liberties. What do they call it? The Patriot Act. On the other hand, we come up with legislation like the Children's Health Insurance Program, and we proudly call it the CHIPS Program, which reminds you of something you have to avoid when you're walking through a cow pasture. Can we start start doing some damn good marketing here, sir, please.
Well, I'll tell you, toward that end, we are fighting to pass a DREAM Act, and I actually think the DREAM Act is well-named. Because
yeah, that actually is, yes.
And we should allow, America is the only country that our dreamers have ever known, and we should be allowing them not only to continue to stay here, but we should be providing them with a pathway to citizenship. The first fatality in the most recent war in Iraq was an immigrant from Guatemala, Jose Gutierrez, who came here as an undocumented immigrant, got his status adjusted, enlisted, like my father, in the United States Army as a legal immigrant, and in Jose's case, made the ultimate sacrifice and got his citizenship posthumously. That's the face of immigrants that this president won't talk about. He only wants to fearmonger. And that's why tomorrow is so darn important, because throw that Daily Beast article in the trash can. Yep. We've got to win elections tomorrow, because we've got to build a better America immediately. Our democracy is on the ballot. We have to make sure we're not only fighting for health care and quality education and the right to form a union and women's reproductive health and climate. We have to restore the institutions of our democracy. That's why this is the most important election of our lifetime. That's why I think I've slept in my own bed once in the last 3 weeks, because we're going everywhere. I'm calling you right now from Milwaukee, where I was just doing an interview with the local Spanish language television station, because you know, we've got about 150,000 Latinos here in Wisconsin who are eligible to vote. I want to make sure they get out and vote. We have invested, not just 2 months ago, but we started investing as soon as I took over at the DNC, because we're a 50-state party. We're an every zip code party. We're taking no one for granted. We're engaging folks everywhere. And what excites me tomorrow, as much as anything, Tom, is the breadth and depth of where Democrats are competing. I mean, we've got a shot to win Kansas. We've got a shot to win South Dakota. We've got a shot in the industrial Midwest to win them all, but only if people show up and vote. That's why this is the election of a lifetime. And that's why I'm so appreciative of what you're doing. And I will observe within the Democratic ranks, there's a unity of purpose around everyone. I appreciate all the work that everyone's doing. I think Senator Sanders will be on your show. This will be the second show in a row where I have appeared right after or right before he has come on. We're going everywhere to make sure people get out and vote tomorrow, because we've got to be all in this together, and we are.
That's great. That's great. The other thing I wanted to ask you about, we now know a BBC reporter sued Brian Kemp and actually got a copy of his purge list, his almost 500,000 people who were purged, and then hired one of the nation's premier direct, and I used to be in this business. I used to own an ad agency, and I know these companies, one of the best direct mail companies in America. They literally update their list daily, and said, compare this purge list to your list of, you know, people that you'd be mailing catalogs to in Georgia right now. And they were able to confirm, and then a whole bunch of phone calls were made to double confirm, that over 300,000 people in Georgia, just in the state of Georgia, on Brian Kemp's purge list, are actually still living in Georgia, have not moved, and have not died. And I'm not hearing anything about this from the Democrats. What are you going to do about these voter purges? We have 14 million people in the last 13 months who have been removed from the voting rolls in 26 states in the United States. That is more than 10% of the number of people who voted in the last election. What are we doing about this?
Oh, we're doing a lot. We've won two lawsuits in Georgia just in the last couple weeks. A lawsuit in Tennessee, a lawsuit. I mean, they're going to cheat everywhere. They can't win in the marketplace of ideas, so you got to make it harder for people to vote. I was in Georgia just this weekend, and part of the reason we are doing so much outreach in African-American, Latino, and Asian-American communities is to make sure that people know they make a plan, because they're trying to make it harder for you to vote. And when you check ahead, for so many people, you just sort of show up and vote because you're going to be on the list. And that's how it should be, but that's not how it is with all of the purging that has gone on and all of there's an array of dirty tricks. I was in Shelby County, Tennessee, which is Memphis, and they've tried to make it harder for African Americans to vote there. I sued Brian Kemp when I was heading up the Civil Rights Division. I mean, he and Chris Kobach of Texas are the chair and the co-chair of the Voter Suppression Task Force of the Republican Party, because they've been doing this for years, and I've been suing them for years. And other folks are out there suing them. And we have built a voter protection operation, not just us at the DNC, but the entire Democratic and progressive ecosystem. There's an army of lawyers down in Georgia, because that will be ground zero. We have this computer tool called LBJ, which helps us identify where are the precincts where we think there's going to be the trouble. So we know the potential trouble spots. We got people on the ground there. That's why all hands need to be on deck. Vote, and then help people secure the vote. That's what folks on this station need to do, because our democracy is on the line tomorrow.
Amen. Tom Perez, chair of the DNC. Thank you, sir.